In this video, I explain the shuttle valve. So here in this image, you see that in a shuttle valve, there is a three port is there. And inside the shuttle valve, there is a ball or a poppet is provided. Okay. And according to this direction of the flow, the poppet or a ball is moved and the flow is carried out according to the direction of the flow supply. Means there is a three different possible cases possible that we discuss here in the detail. The shuttle valve is shown in this figure. Okay, it has a two inlet port A and B and the one outlet port, it is the C. So here you see this is a diagram. This section view is indicate the body, and inside this body, this is the hollow portion is there. Okay, and this is the inlet port A. Inlet port A means here the fluid is supplied, and this is the B port. B port is also the inlet ports. Okay, so either we are supplying the flow, sorry, not flow, but fluid from both the port A and B, or either we supplied from the A port or either we supplied from the B ports. Okay, that is the three case we discuss in the details. And this is the one outlet port, that is the port C. And inside this valve, that is a ball or a poppet is provided. Here you see this is the red color ball is provided. So it consists of a ball or a poppet inside the valve body. So inside the valve body, here you see this is the ball is provided. So in a some type of the valve, instance of the ball, they use the poppet. When working fluid is supplied to any of the two inlet ports, okay, so we have an option, either we supplied from the A port or a B port, or either we supplied from the both the ports. Okay, but here what thing is mentioned, the fluid is supplied to any of the two inlet ports, inlet port A or a inlet port B, and ball poppet closes the other inlet ports and working fluid flow to the cylinder port C. So suppose here we consider that the fluid is supplied from the inlet port A. Suppose it is used in hydraulic system, then we supplied the hydraulic oil. Suppose it is used in a pneumatic system, then we supplied the air or a gas. So when we supply the fluid from the A port, the ball is moved towards the another inlet ports. Okay, so here this B port is closed. So what amount of the fluid enters in A port, it supplied it to the C port, and from the C port it is supplied it to the actuators. Now here you see this is a truth tables for the shuttle valves. So here we done the second case. Okay, so inlet port A is open. At that time what happened? Input B is closed and the output C is there. Okay, now we understand the next case. In this case, the fluid is supplied from the B port. Okay, means this case number 3 here in a table. Okay, so here you see when we supplied at the starting, the ball is here. Okay, so when we supplied the fluid from the B port, the ball is moved towards the A port. Okay, and the A is closed. So here you see input A, no. Input B, yes. And the output in achieve in a C. So fluid enter in a B port is supplied to the port C. And the third one case, that is a here in a table number 1, input from the both the valve, that is input A and input B. Then what happens? So here you see ball at the initial condition at near to this or it is. Okay, so when we supply the fluid from this A port as well as from the B ports, okay, so both the input have a same pressures. Okay, so ball is come in a centers and the fluid is passed from this passage and the outlet is supplied in C port, and from the C port it is supplied to the actuators. In the table, fourth case is mentioned, that is the input A, no fluid is supplied in A port, even no fluid is supplied in B port. Then what happened? Output C is not there. Okay, so it is a simple logical things. Now for the application of the shuttle valve, I make the separate videos, and this is a topic of the circuit design chapters, what is the application of the shuttle valve. For that I provide this link in a descriptions or a card mean on a top right screen of your mobile or symbol, you see the eye symbols. So in this card I provide the video of application of the shuttle valve. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the OHP as well as other subject of the mechanical engineering. For more video, visit the playlist.